Now, the million-dollar question is, as a consumer, how do you go about picking the shaft that is going to best fit your game? And we've come up with a very easy-to-use chart that's going to be a great starting point when selecting the flex and weight shaft to match your game. And there are two references that we're going to use in regards to speed. We have to know the speed of the club at impact. And the first reference can be simply how far you hit your 7-iron, which you'll see across the top of the chart. The second reference that we can use would be your club head speed with your driver. Not everybody knows their club head speed with their driver, but a lot of us do, and we may not know it to exactly the mile per hour, but we roughly know the area that we fall within. And then the second indicator that we have to supply is the length of your swing. And this is important because the amount of speed that you create within a certain time frame is what creates load on the shaft. And to determine load, we need at least two indicators. We need the speed in which the club's traveling, and then the time frame in which it gathers speed to create load. So on the chart that we provide, we can use two indicators for speed. We can either use the player's distance that they hit their 7-iron, or we can use the club head speed of the driver. And then the second is the indicator of time frame. And what we're going to use there is a reference to the length of your backswing. And basically, we can throw all golfers into three categories. And this is something that's just natural to the player, but you have players that have shorter backswings, and for instance, they might swing the club back to vertical or 90 degrees, or if you were to look at an analog clock, 12 o'clock on a clock face. You've got a second player that swings past vertical, but they don't quite get to parallel or horizontal. Maybe they get to 130 or at a 45 degree angle with the shaft at the longest point of their backswing. And then you've got players that get all the way to what we call parallel or horizontal with the shaft. So at the top of the backswing, the shaft's horizontal to the ground. Or again, if this were a clock face, now the shaft is pointing at 3 o'clock. So that is a significant amount of time between those three swings, and the player that stops at 12 o'clock is going to put more load on the shaft, accelerating into impact. The player that swings to horizontal or 3 o'clock is going to put significantly less load on the shaft. So if you reference on the chart where you're at with either your 7-iron or your driver club head speed, and then ask your friends, how long is my backswing? Do I get to 12 o'clock? Do I get back to 45? Do I get all the way to parallel? Let them tell you, or have a buddy take a video of you on your phone and look for yourself. How far back do you get? I feel very confident that if you know the speed in which your club's traveling, again, based either on the distance of your 7-iron, or maybe you've measured your club head speed with your driver, and you know the length of your swing, now we have a real good idea of the load that you put. And using this chart, it'll be a great starting point in selecting the type of shaft that's going to best fit your game.